friends, welcome to all of you in Dr. Jaggi's Academy. Today I am going to discuss about an important reaction of the carboxylic acid, which is known as Kolbe's electrolytic reaction. So in this video, we will discuss the three things. Number one, what is an Kolbe electrolytic reaction? Second one is, what are the different products produced during this reaction? And third one is, how do we get the different product at different electrode? Means we can say that what is the mechanism of this reaction. So let's start. So what is Kolbe electrolytic reaction? Basically, Kolbe electrolytic reaction is given by Herman Kolbe as a scientist. It is used for the preparation of alkanes from the aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid. And this reaction is also known as electrolytic decarboxylation. So first of all, I will discuss what do you mean by electrolytic decarboxylation reaction. So electrolytic decarboxylation is formed by the combination of two words, as seen clearly, electrolytic and decarboxylation. The electrolytic word, they are related to electrolysis, or we can say that electrolytic cell. So electrolysis means the chemical decomposition or chemical change due to the passes of electricity through the electrolyte or a solution containing ions. On the other hand, decarboxylation is also formed by the two words DED and carboxy. DE means removal and carboxy means, or we can say that carboxyl means carbon dioxide. So decarboxylation means removal of carbon dioxide. In a simple word, electrolytic decarboxylation means removal of carbon dioxide from an electrolyte on passing electricity through it. So this is electrolytic decarboxylation reaction. Basically, in Kolbe's electrolytic reaction, there is a removal of carbon dioxide from an electrolyte after passing electricity. So what is a Kolbe electrolytic reaction in which we use an electrolyte? The electrolyte is an aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Means this is a sodium salt of carboxylic acid. When they are dissolved in water, then it acts as an electrolyte. So when the electricity is passed through the aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid, then there is a removal of carbon dioxide from sodium carboxylate ion. So after removal of carbon dioxide, we get a two main product. Number one is alkane and second one is hydrogen gas. Along with the two minor product, that is the carbon dioxide and sodium hydroxide. So in this reaction, on passing electricity through the aqueous solution of the sodium salt of carboxylic acid, we get two products. So we get product. It means there is a chemical reaction take place after passing electricity. So as we discussed earlier, the chemical change due to passes of electricity through the electrolyte, that process is known as electrolysis. So it means there is an electrolysis take place after passing electricity of sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So this is the electrolysis of sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Electrolysis take place in an electrolytic cell which containing two electrode, anode and cathode. So in this case, when electricity pass through the electrolyte in an electrolytic cell, so alkane is produced at anode and hydrogen gas is produced at cathode. So this is the overall electrolytic, Kolbe's electrolytic reaction. So to explain this again, Kolbe electrolytic, I am taking the example of electrolyte. This is a sodium acetate. So we can say that the aqueous solution of sodium acetate acts as an electrolyte. So when the electricity is passed through the aqueous solution of sodium acetate, then there is a removal of carbon dioxide and we get two main product. One is ethane and second is hydrogen gas along with carbon dioxide and sodium hydroxide. So in this case, ethane is produced due to the combination of these two methyl group. And ethane is produced at anode, whereas hydrogen gas is produced at cathode. So how do we get alkane at anode and hydrogen gas at anode? Because in Kolbeck we get main two product, alkane or hydrogen gas. Alkane produced at anode and hydrogen gas at anode. So why do we get, or how do we get these two products at different electrode? Or in one of we can say that what is the mechanism of this reaction? So as we seen, as we know that electrolysis of sodium salt of carboxylic acid take place in electrolytic cell. So what is electrolytic cell? Electrolytic cell in which we have a container which is known as electrolytic tank, in which electrolyte is placed. So here we are using the aqueous solution of the sodium salt of carboxylic acid. And in this container we have a two electrode that dip in an electrolyte, and these rods are known as electrodes. And these two electrodes, they are connected to the battery. The electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery is known as anode and is denoted by the positive sign. Whereas on the other hand, the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery is known as cathode, which is denoted by the negative sign. So in this case, we use the aqueous solution of the sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Means sodium salt of carboxylic acid is dissolving water. So when the sodium salt of carboxylic acid is dissolving water, then both sodium salt of carboxylic acid and water, they are dissociated into ions. This process is known as ionization. So due to ionization, the sodium salt of carboxylic acid produces two types of ion, that is the sodium ion and carboxylate ion. This is the positive ion and negative ion. Whereas in case of similar with the water undergo ionization and produce two types of ion, that is positive ion is hydrogen ion and negative ion is the OH negative ions. So in the case of electrolyte, when we use electrolyte sodium salt of aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid, and we obtain two types of positive ion and two types of negative ion. So next, the electrolysis of this one, what will happen when electricity is passed through this aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid? So here is we have a this aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid, means we have two types of positive ions and two types of negative ions. So after passing electricity through this electrolyte, so when the electricity is passed, then ions of the, they are moved toward the oppositely charged electrode, means positive ion move toward the negative electrode and negative ion move toward the positive electrode, means anode. So this is the on passing electricity, this is the positive ion move toward the cathode, as well as H positive ion move toward the cathode. Whereas this is a carboxylate ion move toward the anode, and OH ion also move toward the anode. So after reaching at the different electrode, means positive ion at cathode or negative ion at anode, then there is a chemical reaction take place and we get a different product. So let's see, so what, how do the reaction actually take place? So in this case, as we know that at cathode, the reduction take place. Reduction means gains of electron. So at cathode, we have two types of positive ion, in this case H positive ion and sodium ion. So out of these two positive ion, both ion they are reduced, but out of these two ions only one positive ion they undergo reduction or gain electron. So in this, so which ion have high tendency to gain electron? So in this case, H positive ion has a greater tendency to reduce as compared to sodium ion, because hydrogen at positive ion has higher reduction potential than sodium ion. So that is why H positive ion undergo reduce, where sodium ion there remain as such. So this is a reduction take place of there is a reduction of H positive ion. Reduction means this H positive ion gains 2 electron from the electrode, and after getting 2 electron, these 2 H positive ion, they are converted to, they are a H hydrogen atom. So these 2 hydrogen atoms, they are unstable, it has tendency to combine. So 2 hydrogen atoms, they are combined to form the hydrogen gas. So it is clearly that at cathode, when the electricity is passed through the aqueous solution of the sodium carboxylate, then H2 gas is produced at cathode. So the general reaction take place, we have 2 H positive at cathode after getting 2 electron, 2 hydrogen atom, and these 2 hydrogen atom unstable combine to produce the H2 gas. So at cathode, on the other hand, cathode, that oxidation take place means loss of electron. So in this case, at anode, we have a 2 types of negative ion. This is a carboxylate ion as well as OH negative. Both ions, they are undergo, they have tendency to undergo oxidation. But out of these 2 ions, only 1 ion undergo oxidation. So which ion undergo oxidation? In this case, this is a carboxylate ion. They are undergo oxidation as compared to OH negative, because this ion has higher oxidation potential as compared to OH negative. Yeah, we can say that this carboxylate has low reduction potential than OH negative. So that is why it has higher tendency to oxidize as compared to OH negative. So only this carboxylate undergo oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electron. So this carboxylate ion loses 2 electron. After losing 2 electron, they are converted into a neutral, this is a molecule, 2RCO negative. Again, 2RCO, this one molecule is unstable. So there is a loss of carbon dioxide, CO2, and these 2 alkyl molecules, they are combined to form the alkane. So in this case, at anode, we obtain alkane as a major product. So the reaction takes place. Here we have at anode carboxylate ion, they loses 2 electrons and converted into a, this is a neutral molecule, this is unstable and it loses a carbon dioxide, and to get alkane and carbon dioxide after the loss of this CO2 compound molecule. So this is a reaction take place at anode, and this is a reaction take place at a cathode. At anode we get alkane, at cathode we get H2 gas, and in electrolyte we have a 2 ions. One is negative ion and second is positive ion, sodium ion and hydro. And these Na positive and OH negative, they are combined to produce NaOH molecule. And this reaction is also used for the production of sodium hydroxide. So this is the electrolysis of aqueous sodium salt of carboxylic acid. So overall always electrolytic reaction. So when the electricity is passed through the aqueous solution of sodium salt of carboxylic acid, then we get a 2 product, alkane along with hydrogen gas, carbon dioxide and sodium hydroxide. So this is a Kolbe electrolytic reaction, and we have studied about what are the different products produced during this reaction and how do we get, means what is the mechanism of this reaction. Thank you.